Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Empyrion. This is Tango. We are ready to get rolling here again, guys. I'm excited. What is that? Oh, more critters. It does that every time. Notice that every time you zoom in, the first time you load the game, it's just like, meh. It like freezes up for a second there. We are here, guys. We are here. Last episode, we started kind of setting the tone and the theme and the style of our base, and I love this little tower here. It's not done. I gotta put little frames up there and stuff, maybe do a little bit more with the gun and stuff. There was a patch today, 5.03 we're on now. They just came out with because the drones weren't attacking people on this planet, so hopefully we'll see the gun put to use very shortly. That is my goal here. But today, guys, today we're going to be touching on one of the things in this game. It's what I think is literally the best thing about this game, is the vehicle construction. Today we're going to build our first vehicle. We're going to build a hovercraft. And the reason for that is because of some of the other stuff they just recently came out with in 5.0, which is you can put drills on your hovercraft and use them as just like gigantic boring tools that dig through the earth and conquer everything, and it's going to be great. I can't wait to try this out. So let me show you what I've been doing here. First of all, I played a little bit off camera here. I'm level 18 now because I've done just a ton of mining. Got a bunch of iron and stuff like that. A little bit of cobalt here and there. But over here on the hover vessel, tech tree, let me show you what we got here. I lit up a ton of stuff here, pretty much everything that's green, okay? So this is all the stuff we're gonna need to build our hover vehicle. Now the hover vehicle, for those of you who don't know, is basically like, you know, picture like Star Wars, like Luke's little his little like, sand runner thing that flies across his planet there, if you remember like in the original Star Wars. Kind of like that. We're going to build one much better than that, though. It's going to look much cooler. So we need a generator, because it's going to need power. We're going to put a fridge on board this thing, so we can keep all our yummy, tasty meats in there to keep us fed. A couple of lighting systems, just because it looks really good at night, and it's actually practical when everything gets dark. A mobile constructor, so that we can like build things right on the ship, and craft things, obviously. Fuel tanks, obvious reasons, we need fuel. O2 tank and O2 station, I'm debating on these. On Akua, this planet we're on here, we don't need oxygen, because obviously I can just breathe. Oh, like my sexy new beard, huh? So awkward. so I'm debating on leaving those off, but we may put them on. We'll see. Weapons, of course, we want weapons on this thing. Now, a Gatling gun and a minigun turret. The difference here, the weaponry is virtually the same, I believe, or close to it. The difference is a Gatling gun is you mount it on your ship and you actually like aim your ship and get crosshairs and you pull the trigger. The minigun turret, you just stick that sucker on top and it's just like, oh, enemy, toast, and it just like waxes anything that comes by you. So we're going to put one of those on there so that we don't have to lift the finger and everything dies. Rocket turrets, maybe. We'll see. We'll see how much space we got. There's like 147 cockpits. I'm not even sure which one I want yet. I may have to unlock more. We'll see. We'll see when we get there. Passenger seat. Now this is cool. You can actually make a ship that like two people can get in. One person can drive, another person can do something else, I think, and like man guns and stuff, which is really cool. I'm not gonna do that on my hover vessel, but I am gonna do that on my small vessel. Now the small vessel is the one that actually flies. The hover vessel just hovers. It's amphibious, it can go over water and stuff. The small vessel is the one that you can just like take into outer space and do crazy stuff with. That one, I think I have ideas for how I want to do that, and I'm definitely going to make that one be a passenger one, so like Impulse can ride shotgun and take the guns and stuff. It should be pretty cool. What else? Oh, wait. Over on the wrong tab here. Wrong tab. Cockpits, passenger seats. All right. RCS. I'll talk about all these things as I put them on the ship, too, I think. But the RCS is like your, I don't even know what it stands for, control system. This is basically the thing that steers your ship and signals power to your various thrusters. So you have two types of thrusters. You have a thruster S and M. Thruster S is side thruster. It's like a lot less power. It's for like lateral movement or for slowing you down. Like you want to have some point at the front. And then thruster M is main, I think, which is like much more boost. And you put those in the back to get going. And the RCS is what drives the control, like when you hit left, right, up, down, or whatever, is what decides how to allocate power to these different thrusters. It's really cool stuff, actually. Hover engine, obviously you need this on a hover vessel. This is what keeps you floated. You need like four of these guys pointing to the ground. Hover Booster is really cool. This is like a, it's kind of like a jump pack for your ship. Like it charges up and once in a while you pop that thing. And I think you can get like a nice jump boost to like jump over stuff. I'm not sure. We'll see. Cargo Box, absolutely want this. As we're drilling things, like the rocks and stuff are going to be on the ground and they're automatically going to get picked up and put into this Cargo Box. I'm not sure if we need a Harvest Module, but this is the guy we're really going for, the Drill Module here now. This thing is like, it's awesome. You pretty much put it like on the front of your hover vessel, and it's like a gun. You just point it at the ground, and it's a little bit hard to use. We'll hopefully do some messing around with it toward the end of the episode when the ship is done. And you just point it at the ground, and it just digs at crazy rates, and then all the rocks are picked up and put in your what do you call it, the Cargo Box there automatically, and it's going to be just awesome. It's going to help so much. Probably put like a few of those on. And then the Drill Turret, this is the one I really want, but I can't get it because it requires, if you see on the right there, it requires advanced CPU and power coils, which, I don't know, it requires some kind of like mombini-boom, elementium, something, unobtainium, that I don't have on this planet. I gotta go to another planet, or I have to find some of the alien bases on this planet. There's like all kinds of POIs and villages and towns and drone cities and stuff that all want to just eradicate me. I'm gonna go visit some of them soon because they've got some like you can get like crazy like elite power up weapons and stuff. I don't know. Yeah, there's so much I have to learn still, but it's gonna be so much fun. And I've also been crafting here. You can see my output here. I actually started banging out some of these things here, so we're pretty much ready to go. All the things that we're gonna need, all the bits and bobs here for this hover vessel. I probably just need a whole ton of actual steel plates. There's my hover vessel starter. So let me get all my business situated here, and we're gonna go up on this little pad here I made. All right, here we go. This is gonna be fun, and it should be interesting to say the least. So this little platform here I built is not a permanent part of my base. I built this because in the past I built vessels in this game, like vehicles in this game, and one of the big problems is getting underneath it. Now, you can, like, turn your ship on and, like, hover it and then get out and then hope it doesn't fly away and things like that. So, instead, what I'm going to do is I built this little platform here. I'm going to build the ship up there. Look how cool that looks with the sun poking through. I like that. And I'll probably, like, bust out, like, four of these grates so that I can get to all the underside guts of the ship and everything. But we'll see. We'll see. I'm not sure yet. I think, yeah, let's go. I'm just going to orient it this way, I think. Actually, should I do it this way? I don't know. Yeah, we'll do it this way. And then I'll do it right in the middle here so that these four can all come out. All right. So obviously we're going to start with our hover vessel starter kit. Now this is what's going to place down the core of it, which is kind of like the really important business of it. I want to get this kind of centered as good as I can here. Let's see. We're going to go like right there. Bam. And fall. Clunk. Okay. So this is telling you which way it's going here. You got the core there. That's the only thing that really matters. So I can take out... do I got my multi-tool? This is something else they just changed recently, too. This multi-tool is, like, merged all together now, which is really kind of cool. So I can break all this stuff, because I know the ship's going this way here, toward that way, which is enough for me. So I'm going to break a lot of this stuff here, okay? Now, part of the game of building a ship here is to make it look really good on the outside, but also hide all of your crazy parts that you need on the inside and protect them, which is another thing. Like, you don't want one drone to come by and shoot a couple bullets at you and your core explodes or, you know, it takes out whatever your generator or something like that. So you want to do your best to kind of hide that stuff below. So I'm going to take some RCS units here. Now, you can have more than one of these. The more you have, the better your vessel, whether it's a hover vessel or a small vessel, the better it will turn. Four may be excessive. I've seen people use six and stuff, but I figured I want to have this thing being really tight controls and stuff. So at least that's my understanding. Correct me if I'm wrong on this, but I think that's how that works. So I'm going to put those RCS guys there. Now, also, guys, I'm going to be straight up honest with you guys. I have done a little bit of experimenting with how I want to do this in a separate, like, creative world where you can, like, you know, fly around and just build the ship you want. There is a whole system for, like, what is it, blueprints? Where you can, like, build a blueprint and save it and import it in. I don't know if you bring a blueprint in survival if it like charges you for the resources or not, but either way it felt a little on the cheaty side. I want to build it myself right here. So all right, so that's our generator going right there. We don't need this right here. Let me take this. Now we want to get on the ever important cockpit here. So I think I want to get this guy. There's like all kinds of cockpits. This is the one I thought kind of looked best for the theme I was going with, like a little rounded top here. All right, so we got that stuff going on there. I think we're good. And now I want to put some blocks in here and kind of slope the front down. So I want to grab these ramp tops here, spin these guys around. All right, there is the slope I was kind of looking for there. So I kind of used three pieces there, one that went down a half, and then another quarter, and then another quarter. Gradual slope there. This is going to be the very front of the ship, obviously. I'm going to put my drill and or drills under there. I'm not sure how many I'm going to do yet. My end goal, like I said, is I want to get... Did I tell you about that? Did I talk about... I don't even think I talked about that. Where is that guy? I really want... Where is it? This guy, the drill turret. So the difference between the drill module and the drill turret. This is like a gun kind of thing you put on the front of your ship, and you got to point your whole ship at the mountain and like manually press the button to drill. It's effective, but really hard, and your ship is all clunking around in the hole and everything, and I don't really want to do that. This guy here, you just put this on, and he's like a gun that you can aim independently. So you just point wherever you want at the nearby terrain. It's like some over there, without your ship having to even move. This thing is way better. The angle of it is a little bit weird, but it's definitely what I want. But so we're gonna have to go with drill modules first, though, because like I said, I don't have those resources. All right, so I got that on now. Like I said, the drills are gonna go underneath there. I'll play with that later. I'm realizing now though that I might have wanted to build this one higher, because. We'll see how this works out. All right, so what I'm going to do now is build the little front little winglets on. They're not even wings. They're just kind of like front things that are going to hold the propulsion units and stuff like that, and some lights and everything. You'll see when they work out, or if they work out. The thing I want to show you, and I'm not even sure if this works in survival now, is they have like a symmetrical build here. So it's weird. Like I can click on this thing now, the plane I want to do symmetry on, and then I can click on... There we go. Okay, so now I'm in like symmetric build mode, and I'll just show you like real quick what this is like. So if I put a block like right here now, bam, it automatically placed another block over on this side. So really, really cool stuff for building vessels and everything, because we can just build one side of the ship and it stays symmetrical. And then I'm pretty sure if I break this side, okay, so I'll have to manually keep them in sync that way. But either way, it's really good. So when you see this mesh here, this green line, that's me building with symmetry turned on. So let me go ahead and try and get the front little thingies going there. Okay, so the good news is I got these little front things on and I like them. I think I have a nice sleek front here, kind of like curving over a bit. But the downside is, like I said, I should build this thing like one block higher, I think. Because now I have to put my theory to the test of breaking out these floorboards and seeing if this thing is going to collapse or not. I'm a little bit nervous. I want to take out everything, these two middle ones here. Now, you can see I've got these little lips here that are on this sideboard here. So if I take out, like, this square here and this square here, it's only going to be resting on these side pieces. And that feels... all right, let's try it. This thing may just collapse. I really don't want to do this. Okay, go. Okay, so far so good. Actually, you know what? I'll just do this and I'll mirror on the other side. Okay, so now I can hop down here and like I'm some kind of mechanic at a garage here. I think this is actually good. All right, hold on, let's see here. This thing will fall if I'm not careful. Okay. Now, you there. What I'm hoping I can do now is put like a block. I wonder if I can do that. Let me see if I can just get a quick angle piece here. So what I want is that to go right there. If I do this, I'm curious if it'll pop up or not. No. Oh, there it goes. It kind of popped. Okay. So I think if I do more of this. Oh, man, it is like hanging on the lip there. All right, let me hop back up there. And lift up. No! Oh, no! Oh, man. What the heck? The whole thing just rocketed. All right. Oh, man. Okay, we're gonna have to work with this over here. Oh, this is not getting better. This is pretty much on the verge of disaster. I've put up a couple pillars here to hopefully prevent my little hover vessel from catapulting itself into the abyss. This is not going. This is not how to build a ship, boys and girls. So I want to try and get this thing leveled out now. I'm going to try and put a block back here, which is hopefully going to lift the back end up, which will hopefully make the front end fall. My frame rate is actually pretty low here because I think the physics are going just mad right now. This could very well be the block that ends it all right here. Oh, I had it. I want to get it right there. Do it. How bad? How bad? Oh, okay. All right. Progress. I'll take it. This will come together, guys. This will come together. Just trust me. Trust me on it. It's going to be great, okay? I got a lot more little bits on here. Let me show you. I got like an ammo box over here. These are the fuel tanks that I originally added. This is the cargo box where anything I mine will automatically go in here. And the fridge is right down there. Now, these are here for a reason because I'll be able to access them from the back. So I can just like go in and take out whatever stuff I got. This is the long construction unit thing, which I think I'll be able to, like, if I get some meat or something, I'll be able to, like, craft some food or something, which will always be good. Yeah, those are the RCS units. That's the core down there. So I think I decided I'm going to go with an oxygen thing just because I wouldn't want to have to retrofit it on afterwards. So we're going to go with an O2 tank right there. And again, that's going to hold the oxygen bottles. And then, you know what, for the life of me, I can't remember. I think there was supposed to be something right there, but I don't know what it was. So we're going to go with the O2 station. How do I want this to look here? It's going to look ugly. I know that. We'll go with that. That seems to be the least obnoxious. Okay, so this is going to be kind of the back. Both of these guys, the oxygen and the construction vehicle, the construction constructor will be available from the back by popping up a little bit. So now that I've got this here, I can actually start adding some of my kind of my body frame on. Where's my wrong key? Where is the thrusters? Let me get some of these guys going. Actually, I'm going to just get one of them going here. Now, this is also another one of these blocks where you can configure how it looks. So this one, I'm going to go with an angle up here, and let's see if we can get it in. That's what I want. Now, rotate it like that. Okay. Boom. Now that guy's going to look good. He's going to be like the upper one, and there's going to be two lower ones like down there and down there. So I have like a little triangle of three rear main propulsion units to give this thing some speed here. Yeah, and again, this is going to be a little bit higher, so you'll be able to peek in underneath here and see the fridge and the cargo box. So let me see if I can get a little bit more of the body out the back here, and we're going to start making some headway into this thing actually looking like a real ship. Now we are getting somewhere. Yeah. All right. I finished up most of the main body here. I'd say it's 90% complete now. We got a couple more things we got to do. Painting it is obviously going to really bring it to life here, but we got to add some more key components here. We got to add our gun and our drill. Now, originally, I was going to place the drill turret down here that was going to allow me to drill like anywhere I wanted to, kind of, sort of. But, like I said, I don't have the materials for that. So instead, I'm going to fall off this cliff here. This is not the worst, best place to work here. All right, I have some spotlights like under here, which are really nice. But I kind of want to take them out, I think, and put. So when you use these drill modules, you really want to like get a lot of them in there. Let me see if I can get them. Is this going to be a pain? All right, hold on here. Let's do this right here. Where's my big steel morph? Who's here? Go there. Thank you very much. All right, good. Now I can kind of look under here. I'm going to put a drill bit there. Uh-oh. Don't spring crazy. No, you're happy? You cool? All right, cool. I thought I was going to just like bounce out like crazy. All right. That one's going there now. You going to be cool sitting inside there? All right. We'll take you guys out in a second. And now this one, though, you want to have like an array of them. Like the tutorial, they like the guys that make Empyrion, they put out a video and they had like six of these things on there. I guess it's just for like better coverage or something. But I want this guy to come out one more. All right, let's put a temp block. Temp block right there. And we'll put this guy right there. Now they're all in line, I think. Yeah.
No! No! No, don't you do that! Don't you do this! Oh, please don't. No! Get in. All right. We're inside. They can't destroy it while we're inside, right?
Are you kidding me? All right.
I can't believe that happened. Okay. Meanwhile, we're going to jump ahead now to the point where we add fuel to this thing. So I can access... A little nervous right now. Okay. we can access all of the components in here. So you can see these are all the things we put on. There's tons of thrusters. There's the RCSs, hover engines, everything. In the fuel tank, I want to put some fuel. Now, we got four fuel tanks mostly because I'm lazy and I don't want them to ever run out. So I'll just build. But I'm only going to do these right now because that's all I got. That's not what I wanted to do. Hit P now to go back to this console here. And I think that should be enough. I should put some O2 in the O2 tank here while I'm here. Boom, 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 boom. Good. Again, I don't ever really plan on using these things. Okay. Why? Turn it on? You gonna let me fly out of here? You gonna let me fly out of here? Are you kidding me with this? No. Oh, I'm gonna hit O. I think O stabilizes me. Okay. All right. Oh, we're up. We're up. We're flying. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Hold on. V? Okay. All right. Check it out. All right. We're rocking here. Left, right, forward, back. Now, all of this is based on where I put my thrusters and how many RCSs I had and everything. Again, like if I forgot to put thrusters on the front there pointing forward, I would not be able to stop this thing. Okay, and I should be able to just hop up here on land. Yep. Okay. I want to hit this. I want to hit this, turn it off, and let me hop out. Okay, I cannot believe that thing catapulted off into the water. okay, let's see here. Hold on. While we're doing this, I guess let's just finish up. Where's the happy? Here we go. This is what's going to keep Mr. Tango safe. We're going to put that guy right there. Bam. Looking good. Oh, this thing's looking so crazy now. The only thing left now is some color. Where's my color tool? Is this it? There we go. All right. I want to paint this thing. I was originally going to do everything matching my base, red and white and stuff. And I was like, that's going to be kind of boring. So we're going to go completely different here and have some fun. I don't know if these are the colors I'll stick with. Let me have this on apply whole block. All right. Again, yeah, I don't know if these are the colors I'm going to stick with here, but I kind of like it right now. We'll see. I can paint everything here. It's crazy. You can paint the thrusters underneath and stuff like that. Let me get all the side business here. I want to show you what style. I'm not going just blue. I'm going to go, let's see. I probably don't want that blue. Anyways, spam, 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 spam. We'll just go all blue here. Oh, I forgot some blocks too. I forgot some blocks. Just spam the blue right now. This doesn't take any resources. So anyways, here's what I wanted to do here. Let me get this, get the gun blue, everything blue, cockpit blue. It's nice that you can color everything. I think it used to be you couldn't color the cockpit, you can only color the blocks. So this is definitely much better now. Okay, it's not completely done. But here's the thing I want to do. I want to do some gold or yellow or whatever you want to call it. And is that what I wanted to do? That's not what I wanted to do. I want to do these. Yeah, we'll do these on the side here, I think. Paint the fuel tanks. Yeah, so you can see I added extra. There's my double fuel tanks right there on the little side humps here. So doing some of this on the side. I think this adds a lot of little color to it, which I like. Might be a little bit too bright, though. I really wish there was just an RGB color picker right here instead of this nonsense here. All right, let's see. We want to do the stripe down the middle here. Can I do it? Can I do it? Good. Nail you. Good. All right, and then the rest will just be blue again. Like this. I think I'll even go blue under there. Blue, 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 blue. Blue, blue, everybody blue. The only one I'm not sure about is... I'm sure I missed a whole bunch here. I'll go back and do a sweep in a second. You like how I hid the thrusters down there? I like that. I think this should probably be yellow right there. Let me pop that guy yellow and that guy yellow. Now, the other thing I wanted to do here, that I'm not done on blocks here, actually. This little extra bit up here, I wanted to add a little pop-out, almost
just like a piece of flair that's just gonna make it look pretty cool, I think. Now, if I can pull this off, I'll be amazed. So, because it's gonna be doing all the angly nonsense, and I want this to be yellow. So, I think what I want is not that guy. Where are you? Where are you? I need the double version. This guy, I think. Let's see if I can put him in there. There we go. We had it right there. Oh, I should be mirroring this. Oh well, too late. Whatever. And that guy's going there. Do the same thing over here now, except flip it around. Bam. And one of these guys there. No, that's totally broken. Totally not the way I wanted to do that. All right, so I'm going to just, in an interest of time, I will fix this here. So I'm going to do, what I want to do is basically make these yellow here. So it's going to look like this, essentially, with a little bit of extra yellow on like kind of like wings thing there. I don't know. Let me get this thing all colored in here, and we're going to take it for a spin and see how it works. Not too bad. Not too bad. She's looking good. I like it. I like it a lot. This is pretty cool. Yeah, the colors are good. Everything's good here. Really happy with how this turned out. Again, eventually these three drills will go away, and I'll just have the one drill turret there. But let's go. Let's go take it for an actual spin and see if we can do some mining here. See if we can not crash. Going backwards. How easy is it going to be for me to turn around? Oh, duh. I actually have to use the mouse. I'm trying to use the keyboard. Where are we going? We're going to go over here. Now, let's see how fast I can hit this, if it causes a problem or not. Kind of bumped a little bit there. Didn't like that at all, really. I want to go try and hit these mountains up here now. Let's see. If I can climb up over these mountains, that'll make me happy. Oh, this thing is fast. Oh, I like it. Excuse me. Pardon me, boys. Coming through. Drilling them all up. What? Wait. The heck is that noise? Do I have an animal stuck under my hood? Can I take you out? Oh, I forgot to put ammo in this thing. No? What is that noise? That pow, 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 pow. I don't know what that is. It's kind of weird. Alright, let's see if I can make it over some of these hills here. Oh, you see my turret's aiming automatically. It wants to shoot. Oh, yeah, I can just make it over all these guys. Motorcycle, you are done. Not touching you anymore. Woo. So it doesn't really fly, but it hovers. And it does that really well. Alright, let's try to mine. I really wish I got ammo. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. Hold on. P. Where's my ammo box? I thought I had... Oh, is it small? Small ammo box. There we go. And I think this is the ammo this thing needs. Oh, yeah. It sure is. Get them, boys. Who wants some? Huh? Anybody else want some? I can't see who you're shooting. Oh, it's just free meat for days. Now look, I could just like hop out of this thing. I'm totally safe. Anything comes up on me. Oh, spoiled food. Why you give me spoiled food? I don't want your spoiled food. Oh, do I not get spoiled food when it... I bet you I don't get spoiled food. Or I bet you I do get spoiled food when my turret kills it so that I can't just hunt this stuff. Let's see if this is spoiled. No. I'll take that. I wonder what the trigger is for spoiled food or not. I don't know. Anyway, what? You're ripping through all my ammo, man. I gotta change this thing. I know you can change it to like... Oh, where is it? Where is it? Minigun turret. Okay, I can set it to turn predator off. And I think it's gonna turn those. Now, that does mean that it won't protect me now, though. I should really check all the bits here. But I want to drill. I want to drill. Let's go. Where is there? Is this one I haven't touched over here? No, this is the main one I've been using. Let's not go there. All right. Well, what do we got over here on the map? We got cobalt and we got iron. Let's go hit up some more iron over here. Oh, that's magnesium. Oh, iron's right to my left. Where is it? Where is it? Oh, it's right down below me. Okay. Now, let's see how this works here. It's like right below me. This is the part I'm not 100% certain about. You gotta like really kick it back and push into the ground here. Yeah. It is so much faster than, look at these guys. Oh, now I might want to have that. I didn't put the booster on. Look at the size of the hole I dug already. That was crazy. Just instantly like that. Oh yeah, the triple digger action. This is nice. Now, if you look in the bottom left there, excuse me, buddy, excuse me, coming through. If you look over on the side there, it's automatically picking up all this stuff. So nice. Such a nice improvement. This is great. Now I can hit P and go to my... Where is it? Cargo box. Access it. Oh, look at that, crushed stone, iron ore. That would have taken me way longer to do the old way. This is so much better here. I gotta use O. O is like the automatic stabilize button. I don't want to get stuck in here. Definitely takes some getting used to here. Let's see if I can... Can you get me out? Uh-oh. I should be able to just dig straight out here. Go, 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 and then hover it out. I said hover it out. Yeah, can we do it? Can we do it? Can we do it? Can we do it? Get me out. Get me out. Come on. Come on. Yeah, I need those boosters, definitely. Am I stuck? Please don't tell me I'm stuck in here. I really would like to get out now. Let's try doing it this way. There we go. There we go. There we go. Okay. Okay. I am pleased. This thing is awesome. It needs a little... I got to learn how to drive a little bit better. Got to decide if I want to have predators be killed automatically or not. But wow, what an upgrade over the motorcycle. This thing is great. Let's see if I can run these people down. Out of my way, people. Blah. No. No such luck. All right, that's going to do it for today, guys. I am very happy with the outcome of this thing. I can just drive it up on water here. Next episode, maybe we'll do some exploring. Maybe we'll do some more base work. I really want to work on this base some more and kind of keep that theme going. But I hope you guys don't mind. This was a long episode, but I really do appreciate you watching. If you enjoyed it, hit that like button, and I will see you guys next time for more Empyrion. Later.